What's going on today, guys? Welcome back to an episode of WNN. I'm your host, Why Do You Keep Doing This? And today we'll be talking about the music production news. Hope you guys are excited. There is a lot of news. In our first story, Ableton Live is now in 11.3 public beta, and it features a new synth named Drift. You can get this now if you have a legitimate copy of Ableton Live 11. First when I saw this picture, I thought that was someone's like hairy leg right there. Drift is said to be capable of generating sounds from every era of modern music and has a minimalist design that Ableton believes makes it beginner friendly. However, we're sure there's also enough depth to keep experienced sound designers interested. Apparently it's inspired by classic hardware. It's even included in Ableton Live Lite. That's actually surprising. Analog, Collision, Electric, and Tension are now MPE friendly. Nothing really funny about that. It actually just sounds good. DistroKid still hasn't paid their royalties, man. Thankfully they sent me this DistroKid nail clipper though, because I'm getting pretty hungry. In our next story, we'll be talking about one really expensive interface. Try to guess it down below in the comments. Interesting. I do like how it has visuals on it, but that shit's gonna be expensive, I can guarantee it. The missing jewel. Is that the jewel? It looks like a fake diamond, to be honest. Because even with the best possible gear, you're losing potential in your signal chain. Complicated settings, noise, limited dynamic range, DA conversion losses, AD conversion losses, mediocre mic preamp, insufficient gain, weak output for headphones. Whoa, that looks sick, dude. Wait, whoa, you can adjust the compressor on it? Oh, that's fucking tight. Dude, adjusting the compressor on, I don't know why that gets me off so much. I wanna do that. Looks like a limited amount of inputs and outputs though. AD conversion with 4x the resolution of competing devices, 78 dB gain, 0.035 ohms output drives any headphones to their best, which exceeds external headphone amps, 4 internal mixers, EQ dynamics, processing, and reverb. It's got connectivity for everything. Record raw and process audio streams simultaneously. That's kind of cool. I'm not gonna lie, I want it. I really want it. How much does it cost though? I'm scared. I know this thing's gonna be expensive. It's £1,750.
Holy shit.
Can't say I'm surprised with all those features, but goddamn, that is expensive. I'm just salivating over this thing. It looks amazing. Warning for California residents only. This product can expose you to chemicals, including lead. What? Nah, they have to give this warning in California. Even this hydration drink I have has this warning on it. It got me concerned too when I first saw it. You didn't believe me about the nail clippers? Sucks to be you. In our next story, BusyWorks Beats is running for president. It's time to give power back to the producers to take on the bad actors within the producer community and audio companies, create producer partnerships and sponsorship advocacy, and take on the dark side of the music industry. Join me in the producer movement. He seems like the guy for the job, man. He really seems like the guy for the job. And somebody doxed me in his Discord server earlier today. Okay, well, let's take a look at it anyways. BusyWorksBeatsClickFunnels.com. I mean, I'm gonna be real. I don't think I could trust someone using a click funnel for this, especially when it's in the website. A message from Game of BusyWorks Beats. Listen, Busy, you know, I like you sometimes, but this is ridiculous, man. This is really cringe. And I also don't think you are in a position to be the person worrying about bad actors or bad companies. Where's your video calling out Akai and Timbaland? I know you did the thing with the CLA Wu situation, but that's like the only thing I've ever seen you do, really. Where are your videos calling out Unison Audio? Where are your videos calling out basically every other bad actor in the community? Where are they? Called out Waves, I guess, but literally everyone and their mom did that. My mom has a video about that. I risk sponsorships and business relations from billion-dollar brands to serve the producer community. Who are the bad actors within the producer community? I feel like, he's describing what I do and then attributing it to himself. I feel like a more accurate description of what he does is I teach people how to make type beats. I do an okay job at it. That's like, I feel like that realistically that's what he does. Producer community to save, and I'm not giving up now, and I know you aren't either. What are we saving it from? Like, I know there's some shady companies and whatnot, but just call them out. Like, what do you, I feel like this is just a trick to get people's name, email addresses, and phone numbers. In light of this, I also decided I am going to be running for president. Vote Weaver 2024. We will find the bad actors and show them the door. It's getting hot in here. In order to vote for me, all you have to do is subscribe. Make sure to subscribe and like the video. That's how you cast your vote. When there was a Unison Audio, I said, hell yeah. When there was a Wave scandal, I also said, hell yeah. When Kyle Beats struck down my videos, I said, hell yeah. Vote Massive Hater, a man you can trust to hate. This segment was paid for by the Weaver Beats 2024 Presidential Commission. I just want you to know, I did not inhale. In our next story, Phaseplant now has a granular engine.
Woohoo!
And obviously, the Phaseplant granular update is free. Sounds granular. Pretty cool interface. Never heard of this before. The Phase Plant. I know about a lot of plugins. I mean, on one hand, I want to say granular stuff is like so overdone at this point, but it's cool they added it as a free update in Kilohertz Phase Plant. So, I mean, I'm not going to complain about that.
Today, we finally release our brand new granular generator for Phase Plant. We're more than a little bit excited.
This guy's the opposite of me. You guys complain about me blinking too much in my videos. This guy has not blinked once this entire time.
I can tell you, we're about 1,000.
This guy's a robot. What the fuck? Okay, blink once if you're being held hostage.
Today's the day we finally release our brand new granular generator.
Okay, I think he's all right. So you can have multiple granular generators in a single patch, combine them, cross-modulate them. Looks like pretty much any other granular thing I've seen in the past. There was no collusion, guys. Everybody knows there was no collusion. Speaking of which, we have another granular plugin. A free one. Granular Encoder, free ambisonic granular plugin by IEM. It's open source, Windows and Mac OS. Works like a cheese grater for audio. That just sounds like granular to begin with, though. So this one does seem a bit interesting. It has a 2D mode as well as a 3D mode. 2D mode is based on a circular distribution of the audio grains. The user can adjust the grain spread in a two-dimensional space. Depending on the mix parameter value, the output can sound either as an ambisonic granulator or an ambisonic grain delay. Easier to operate, works great as a creative effect, and you can blend in with original audio. 3D mode, more advanced, obviously. I mean, I feel like they didn't even have to state that based on the name there, but yeah. Based on the spherical distribution of audio grains, allowing more complexity, the user can fine-tune the azimuth, elevation, size, and shape of the grains. It's free, it's only 75 megabytes, and it contains 21 individual plugins. What the fuck? It's got a multiband compressor, EQ, reverb. Guys, if I was Two-Faced, would I be wearing this one? In our next story, Diddy reportedly pays $2,000 a day to Sting for a sample that he did not clear. Oh wait, it's actually $5,000 a day. Honestly, if that was me, I would just end it all. So obviously I'm reading like presidential quotes, right? Yeah, this one by George Bush here, I don't even think I could say that. Is that real? I don't think I should be saying that one. I don't think he should be saying that one either. In our next story, Arteria has a new reverb plugin named the LX24. It is supposed to emulate a Lexicon reverb. Released in 1978, Lexicon's 224 remains one of the best-selling and most loved digital reverb units of all time. In fact, it's still in use today. I think it's funny how when they emulate a plugin, they will just like slightly tweak the name so that they can be like, oh, well, it's not the same name. And in this case here, they took Lexicon 224 and shortened it to Lex 24. Yeah, I definitely don't see the similarities there. Okay, so it's got an introductory price of $69, normal price $99. It has a free demo as well too. Sounds pretty good. This demo's fire, dude. A lot of times the demos suck for plugins and pretty much everything, but this demo is actually insane. That ad alone makes me want this. In our next story, GPU Audio has released a free impulse response pack. I'll link that in the description along with everything else here. It contains 50 IRs from a huge range of sources. The pack is available to use royalty free. I mean, I would hope so. Jesus Christ. GPU Audio will be hosting the Innovation Lounge at NAMM. Oh, I'll be there. In our next story, you can get the Firepressor plugin for free. They have a discount going on right now until April 16th. So make sure to get that if you'd like. My fellow Americans, I am pleased to tell you I've signed a legislation with Russia. The bombings begin in 5 minutes. In our next story, 100 Gex has said this about Skrillex. He has all this gear and all these synths, but then it's just uses his laptop, no monitor, no mouse, nothing. He's just going raw. Literally no mouse even. That's actually insane. That is mentally insane. He does make some good music, especially his newer stuff. In our next story, Spotify is shutting down its live audio app. I'm going to be honest, I didn't even know it existed. No, and I'm not talking about their main Spotify app. Spotify Live? I've never even heard of this. I can't be the only person. Previously known as Spotify Green Room. Interesting, it must look like I'm in a green room right now. We believe there's a future for live fan creator interactions in the Spotify ecosystem, they continued. However, based on our learnings, if it no longer makes sense as a standalone app. We've seen promising results in the artist-focused use case of listening parties, which we will continue to explore moving forward to facilitate live interactions between artists and fans. I mean, no wonder it wasn't doing well. I didn't even know it existed. I'm sure I'm not the only one. People say I'm indecisive, but I don't know about that. All right, there's a free instrument for contact that is, get this, Bike Bells.
Hey everybody! Our new free instrument for this month, Bike Bells, has just been released. Therefore, I'd like to show you how you can use it in your own projects.
Are these made with bike bells? It just sounds like normal bells. Maybe they're the same thing.
We record it from random bicycles. The last sound has a longer attack than the others.
Can't imagine why I'd ever want this, but okay. In our last story for the night, CV2 modular update. It has new modules, some workflow improvements, new sound packs, and crucially, you can finally use it with inputs as an audio effects plugin. And of course, Venus Theory is doing the video for it. I've seen Venus Theory in so many product demos at this point, it's actually insane. I'm convinced there's clones of him. They're using different clones of him to do all of these. So some new modules it has, a 3-band splitter, compare, crossfader, crusher, EQ filter, left-right, mid-side, mid-side, left-right for mid-side, matrix processing, microfilters, panner, saturator, stereo mix 5, stereo utility. They've updated a few other modules as well too. Normally it's $149, sale price $99. I think I'm actually very humble. I am much more humble than you could ever understand. Okay, guys, that's it for this episode of WNN. I'm your host, Massive President. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to like it. For everyone who likes this video, I will give you one presidential campaign. You will get to run for president and potentially win. Sound good? If you made it to the end of the video, comment fish. If you guys want to support the channel, consider joining my Patreon or becoming a channel member. Check out my second channel if you haven't. We upload there almost every single day as well. I'll see you guys next time.